In this KTAB update, you may have seen Clay Rodman's picture on billboards across the key city, and police and families still receive tips about what happened to him almost 6 years ago. He's been missing since 2013. And as Claire Kreitz reports, the family is still hoping to find out what happened to him.
When I hear the trains, I'm always thinking of Clay because I connect that to Abilene.
May 1st, 2013, Clay Rodman was booked into the Taylor County Jail for public intoxication and released that same day. But once he walked out those doors, Clay would never be seen or heard from again.
Once he was released is where the questions began as to where he went and the circumstances as to why he went missing.
1 month later, Alan Rodman reported his son missing to the Abilene Police Department.
He had reason to believe that he was endangered.
That's where Detective Joshua Ward began his investigation.
There have been several people that we have looked into that possibly have information pertaining to the circumstances of Clay's disappearance.
From billboards, flyers, and even hiring a private investigator, Clay's family determined to get answers.
No physical evidence. Makes it real hard. All you've got is just two or three stories that match up a little bit.
Throughout the years, these stories continue. In 2017, 4 years after Clay's disappearance, police received a tip his body could be found at this home on the 3900 block of Old Anson Road. But unfortunately, this turned out to be just another dead end.
The whole family feels completely comfortable that Clay did die in the month of May. Some don't know the date. It was probably sometime in the first half of May. 2013. We feel comfortable with that. We've fully accepted that.
Despite coming to terms with Clay's death.
Well, here's another set of billboards. This is the last set we had up back last year.
His family continues the search.
As long as the billboards are there, it's a reminder to the public that someone knows what happened to him, and we're still looking for him.
Not for a conviction, but reunification, however that may be.
If it needs to come anonymously, that's fine. You know, just. And there's ways to do that. And then we could go find Clay's body and give him a proper burial and have a closure to it.
Hoping someday they'll get the answers they've been seeking for almost 6 years now. In Abilene, with coverage you can count on, Claire Kreitz, KTAB News.
Thank you, Claire. The private investigator hired by the family is still conducting interviews, and both he and APD tell us they will exhaust every lead until Rodman is found.